book of Ephesians chapter 5, follow the way of love. The example of Christ who loved you, he gave himself up for us and became the offering and sacrificial victim whose fragrance rises to God. He became a sacrificial lamb, and to the outside the world he is a sacrificed lamb, but from that lamb fragrance of life, fragrance of salvation came into the world. Yes, everything that is offered to the Father brings forth life and salvation. Yes, my dear friends, God has chosen each one of us. For what? Jesus saying, if anyone wants to follow me, take up your cross and follow me. What is this cross? The cross means it's not a burden that my life has become a cross that I have to carry. For some, their husbands have become cross. I have to carry him. For some, the wives have become the cross. Yes. No. Cross is the symbol of, sign of bringing salvation and life to this world. On the cross, he shed his blood for us. And through the blood, he destroyed the powers of darkness. The cross is the place where the presence of heaven, presence of salvation is brought to this earth. What is deliverance? Deliverance means remain in the light. As long as the light is there, the darkness has no place to enter into. So deliverance comes that something the enemy has entered into us. So we need to realize immediately, get back to the light. And once we get back into the light, as we read in John chapter 12, it says, he who walks in the light walks in his presence, and the enemy can never come in. Yes. But one who walks in darkness, he doesn't know where he goes, and he falls. Yes. God is calling each one of us and giving us the gift of the cross. This holy cross is our life. So in our home, in our church, everywhere we keep up the cross. And this cross continues to give us life and salvation. So number one, when we see the cross, we know that the cross has become salvation. Jesus shed the blood on the cross. Like the people of Israel, they took the blood of the lamb and they kept it on their door, and the evil could not enter into that house. In the same way, we the children of God realize our life is a cross. We too, like the master, go through trials, temptations, problems and sin. But keeping the cross before us, we move ahead in life. Cross, as we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 18, it is the power of God to guide God's children. For others, it's, on the cross, Jesus died a horrible death. For us, it is on the cross he has brought salvation. The same way, God gives to each one of us the cross to carry in our life. Cross here means it is not something burden. As I said, cross means a way of life in which we have to go through various steps of suffering, pain, struggle. There are some people, a group of people who commit their lives to become somebody in the world, to build up something, to achieve something. And other group of people are busy in eating, drinking and wasting their life. But there is a group belong to the cross. Like the master, they go ahead, here I am. Here I am. Offer themselves and bring life and salvation to the world. Recently, a man who was a boatman in the ship in the sea, when he came for the holidays, was a very bold man in the Kerala flood. So everybody got frightened. He used his body like a staircase. He offered it. So many people climbed on his, old people, women, everybody. They used his back as though like a staircase. They climbed on his back and they got into the boat. His nose was always on the water, and that water was contaminated with so many sickness. So many animals died. But everybody was standing and trying to help. This man kept his nose down. He became a staircase, bowed down, so people could climb on him and get. And then soon, suddenly, he became sick, so much fever, and he had no time. And by the time he realized, the fever became so acute, they took him to Trivandrum. By the time on the way, he passed away. His mother, her name is Annie Kutty, when they asked her, "You are a Catholic woman, your son has died like this, helping so many people. What do you say?" She said in Malayalam that, "My son was wearing the cross on his neck always. And whenever he goes to the sea, he used to kiss the cross and go. He joined with Jesus and his cross, and he saved many, and he died. Now he has gone to heaven to receive his reward." Cross was his inspiration. Cross was his life. That his mother says, he joined with Jesus and his cross. He saved many, like Jesus saved mankind. Today you and I are kept in a place where there are so many problems, so many situations. People of this world, they will not take risk. They will not lay down their life. In the people of this world, if I spend 10 rupees, will I get another 10 rupees? This is the world. What to gain? What to get? How to build? How to become big? How to establish myself? Though they knew that what they establish is not going to stand with them. They walk so many miles. Why do you walk? To keep myself fit. Okay, certain limit, okay. But the whole time, the whole life is taking care of oneself. So there are so many people spend their life for various things. Definitely we have to take care of our health. I'm not saying that. But to establish themselves, to save themselves, to protect themselves, to become great. At the end of the day, they too have to become old. Whether they like it or not, you may apply any cream, but the hair will become white and they have to go to mud. Your life is once. Look at the cross. The cross is the source of life. God so loved the world, he laid down his life for us, that not a single one should perish, but everyone should have life. So today, God has given to you and me the precious gift of life. Before our age goes away, before we become old, before we close our eyes, keep the cross. Keep Jesus on the cross. Become source of life and salvation. Don't get, because of your life involves pain, your life involves risk, don't run away. That's what the people of the world do. No. You have to take risk sometime and live for God. Commit your life. The cross is our power. The cross is our strength. That's why we read In Jeremiah chapter 9 verse 1, Jeremiah says, my people have become victims in Babylon. How I wish my head becomes a river and my eyes become a canal that I can bring forth water and I go on cry for my people. Yes, I want to lay down every drop of my tears for my people. Yes, that's why the Bible, 1 John chapter 3 verse 16, it is written, as God laid down his life and became source of life to this broken world, we too should lay down our life by looking at the cross, and we become source of life to this broken world. God is calling each one of us.